Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Just a reminder that today we can expect another Falcon 9 launch. In fact, by the time I upload this video, it should have lifted off. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Transporter 5 is scheduled to lift off at 6:27 PM UTC or 2:27 PM EDT. There was an article posted related to a Falcon Heavy launch which has been delayed. It says the launch of NASA's Psyche asteroid mission, which was set for August 1st on a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket, has been delayed to no earlier than September 20th after ground teams discovered an issue during software testing on the spacecraft, officials said Monday. SpaceX posted an interesting tweet related to Starlink capabilities. They said, Starlink for RVs can be used anywhere. Starlink provides service and is ideal for camping and other activities in rural or remote locations where internet access has been unreliable or completely unavailable. In response to Musk posting a tweet about this information, he was asked, any plans for Africa? Musk responded and said, yes, first countries in Africa to be announced soon. Starlink will serve everywhere on Earth that we are legally allowed to serve. There was another tweet posted saying this will be great for first responders and disaster relief efforts, coupled with 5G microcell and instant infrastructure. Musk responded with, absolutely. Normal connectivity is often lost when there are wildfires, storms or flooding, but Starlink still works. Michael Sheetz also posted a tweet about this news with a response from Elon Musk. He said, SpaceX rolled out Starlink for RVs for $135 a month, which provides the ability to pause and unpause service at any time and is billed in 1 month increments. Notably, Starlink for RVs is not designed for use while in motion. Musk responded with, Starlink does work on vehicles in motion, including planes, but not yet reliably. There was another Starlink related tweet posted with this one from Jonathan McDowell. He said, SpaceX have confirmed that current Starlink designs no longer have visors but do have improved coatings. This is consistent with observations showing a typical 0.5 magnitude brightness increase of the new satellites relative to visor sats. There was a tweet asking Elon Musk if he uses Starlink whilst he's flying on his plane. He said, yes, I am testing Starlink on the plane. Some polishing needed, but it's working quite well. There was an interesting tweet from Musk in response to an infographic with stats about deaths per 1 billion passenger miles for each vehicle type. He said, Starman Roadster has travelled enough to have driven every road on Earth 52.8 times. There was a CNBC article posted about SpaceX looking for more funding. It says, SpaceX is raising a massive round of fresh funding, CNBC has learned, sending the private company's valuation to about $127 billion. The space venture is looking to bring in up to $1.725 billion in new capital at a price of $70 per share, according to a company-wide email on Friday obtained by CNBC. There's been some news recently of Crew Dragon issues with heat shields as they tested a new heat shield which failed acceptance testing. There was a tweet posted about this news with a statement from NASA. It says, a statement from NASA on the Dragon heat shield concern, which is not associated with any recent re-entry but with a new composite heat shield structure that failed SpaceX's acceptance testing for the upcoming Crew 5 mission. Crew 5 will now use a different heat shield structure. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. A new piece to go on the back of the booster quick disconnect has been installed. A substantial amount of methane has been delivered recently for possible static fire testing soon. Here's a view of suborbital pad A, which was recently prepared for testing. The roof of the mega bay is continuing to be constructed in the production yard. Also continuing to progress is the staff factory production building being put together. Crews have been continuing to work on the booster transport stand. Some SPMTs were loaded onto trucks and hauled away from Starbase. There was a tweet posted by S. Padre about a newspaper article related to the Starship environmental assessment. It says, US FWS report to FAA, risks to all species can be mitigated with basic measures would not represent an adverse modification. Much like the Cape where wildlife flourishes and coexists with a much busier launch cadence, I'm excited to see SpaceX conservation efforts. There was a very exciting couple of tweets posted by Eric Berger in relation to the FAA decision on the environmental assessment. He said, "We are 1 week away from the FAA's latest deadline to complete the environmental review process for SpaceX's launch site in South Texas. This time, my expectation is that there will not be another extension. Likely decision, a mitigated FONSI. This means SpaceX is likely to get approval to move ahead with experimental launches of Starship, however they will have to make some accommodations for environmental impacts. This is what I am hearing, but you should not consider it official information." Felix from What About It posted a tweet with an image of the five orbital launch integration tower segments at Roberts Road. He said, "SpaceX Starbase 2 at Kennedy Space Center Roberts Road is growing fast. Five megazilla segments standing tall. Stacking might begin soon. The Ship 16 tank section is now sitting out in the yard. The Starship 25 nose cones heat shield tiles are almost complete now. Looking at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, the possible closures for the start of this week were cancelled. There are, however, further possible closures for the remainder of this week. Currently, there are possible closures for today, Wednesday 25th, tomorrow, Thursday 26th, Friday 27th, as well as next week with Tuesday 31st. As always, I have to say thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thank you to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming some of the Boca Chica content in this video too. As well as that, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.